द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इन प्लानिंग दैट इज लिमिटेशंस ऑफ प्लानिंग. सो हियर लिमिटेशंस आर नथिंग बट द डिसएडवांटेजेस और ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ प्लानिंग. सो वेयर जस्ट नाउ ओनली वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बेनिफिट्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट बाय मेकिंग द प्लानिंग इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन्स अबाउट व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स that are associated in the function. There are mainly 6 problems or demerits which are associated with the function of planning. So we discuss each and every disadvantage with explanation. The first limitation of planning is planning leads to rigidity. So here the word rigidity means inflexible. The word rigidity means inflexible. So where once the plan is set and executed in organization, it cannot be changed at any time. So generally the plan is to be prepared by top level managers as per the direction of top level managers. All the other officers, they need to work in the organization. So that is why planning leads to rigidity. Once you set a plan, once the plan is implemented in organization, means it cannot be changed again and again. So that is why planning is going to leads to rigidity. So very simple, once you set a plan, once you implemented the plan, so it cannot be able to change at any time. So that is why planning is going to leads to rigidity in the organization. Say for example, you made a plan to manufacture 10,000 units. Already I gave an example, the same example I'll continue. So you made a plan to manufacture 10,000 units in the month of April. So but in the month of April a lockdown has came, so it is difficult to implement or it is difficult to execute the plan which is being prepared. So that is why we cannot able to change once the plan is to be set. That is why planning is going to leads to rigidity. So once the plan is set and executed in organization, it cannot be changed again and again. So that is why sometimes it will also going to failure in the organization. That is one drawback, that is planning leads to inflexibility in organization. Then second limitation is planning may not work in a dynamic environment. As you know, dynamic means adapting to the change. So as you know, environment is not constant. Always the environment is change in nature. So once you prepared the plan, so if any changes made in the external environment, your plan will not be achieved properly. So that is why where the planning is completely based on anticipation and imagination, that is why we cannot able to assume all the anticipation, all the happenings in future exactly. So that is why where it may not work in a dynamic environment. Say for example, you made a plan to manufacture 10,000 units in a month, but suddenly lockdown has came because of COVID-19. So we are not assumed that. So it will going to happen like that. So that is why where planning is based on anticipation, and all the changes cannot be assumed perfectly. So that is why whatever the changes made in the external environment, so we cannot able to go through that. So that is why the planning is going to get a failure in the enterprise. That is why planning may not work in a dynamic environment. So this is about the second limitation. Then third comes, that is, planning reduces creativity. So as you know, creativity means thinking about new things, that is innovative. So planning reduces creativity. This point is related to advantages. In advantages, we learned that planning promotes creativity. But in disadvantage, we are learning that planning reduces creativity. How it possible? It means where the plan is set by top level managers. As you know, there are three levels: top level, middle level, lower level. So who is going to prepare the plan? Top level manager is going to prepare the plan. As per that, the middle level manager must execute the plan. So while executing the plan, the middle level managers, they cannot able to use their own ideas, their own views and their own thoughts, because in the initial stage only we are going to encourage the innovative ideas, but while implementation it cannot able to possible. So that is why where the planning reduces creativity, so it not allowed to work on their own. So where once it is set and implemented, it is difficult to promote new ideas. Once you set the plan, it cannot be able to change. Once you implemented the plan, it is difficult to use the creative knowledge and creative abilities. That is why it does not allow the work, it does not allow to work on their own interest and own wish, because it is to be stated by top level managers. As per their direction only, the middle level managers must work. So it does not allow to use their creative abilities while implementing the plans. This is about the third limitation. Then fourth comes, that is, planning involves huge cost. So it means planning requires more amount. So where we need to implement the plan, we need to prepare the plan, means it will going to require more amount of money. So because it requires experts to analyze the data, it requires certain anticipation, making the calculation. Based on that, we are going to incur more amount of expenditure. So that is why where preparation of plan requires collection of data, analysis of data and calculation of all the data which are being collected. So those all are to be done by the experts. To get the work by the experts means we need to pay higher amount of salary or remuneration. So that will going to leads to huge cost in making the planning function. So that is why planning involves huge cost. Why you are spending more amount of money means in a collection of data, in analysis of data and in making the scientific calculations of data to make all these activities, who is to be required? We required experts. To get the work from experts, we need to pay more amount of salary or remuneration. That will going to leads to the more cost. That is why planning leads to, or planning involves huge cost. Then fifth is, planning is time consuming. So it means where it requires more time. So here planning requires more time to prepare and implement our objectives, because lot of time is needed in developing planning premises and to prepare a plan. It is not a simple way. So there are a lengthy process, where there is a lengthy process, series of steps that are to be followed in implementing and preparing a plan. So that is why the plan will not be set in a day, and plan will not be set very quickly. So it requires collection of data, analysis of data, calculation of data, and anticipation of future activities. To make all these criteria, it will going to require more amount of time. So that is why planning is a more time consuming process. We cannot able to set a plan in a day, and or it is difficult to prepare a plan quickly. So it requires the sufficient time, so then only we can able to prepare the plan. So that is why the fifth limitation is, planning is time consuming process. Then last, that is, planning does not guarantee success. That is, it is highly difficult that what is going to happen in future, we cannot able to predict and we cannot able to assume. So because the future is completely filled with various kinds of uncertainties, that is why the planning may not be successful in all situations, because external factors are not constant. The external factors are always changing in nature. So if you prepared a plan, if any changes made in the external environment, that will affect on non-fulfillment of the plan of the enterprise. That is why it may not be successful in all situations when the external factors are changing in nature. So that is why the plan is not implemented properly by the experts in the organization, the plan will be failed in the enterprise. That is why planning does not guarantee success. This is all about the six limitations or six drawbacks of planning. Once again, I'll repeat the points. Planning leads to rigidity. Planning may not work in dynamic environment. Planning reduces creativity. Planning involves huge cost. Planning is a time consuming process. Planning does not guarantee success. This is all about the limitations or disadvantages or drawbacks, or even though it is also called problems of planning. Thank you.